also to accept it. It is said that others are not happy to be impressed in this way. If in this way you don't want them to have this happiness, then since it makes them happy, we should cease giving weight and the light to your silence. However, you would be adversely affected both in this and the future lives. When people describe my own qualities, I want others to be happy too. But when they describe the good qualities of others, I do not wish to be happy myself. So this is the here is some teaching about Shantideva, actually how to control this anger. We are talking about afflictive emotions of the anger and the hatred. So here is some explanation and some method given by Shantideva. And if we contemplate one by one, we will be able to control this negative and afflictive emotions like anger and hatred. So here, number one method is when from the Buddhist perspective, who created the anger? Who created this anger? It is coming from external, or who is creating this, your anger or the affective emotion. So here Shantideva gives some explanation. So who created, for example, like your vote, or your vote. So when we are talking about, somebody hurt you, right? So talking over here, like the body will eventually cause you some kind of pain, but it does so unintentionally, so it is would be silly to get angry at your body. Sometimes we feel pain, that unconditionally we experience, and like body pain, or we experience kind of like sickness of the body and something like this. But so body, this cause pain does so unintentionally. So it is very silly to get angry towards your body. So similarly, when somebody hurt you, so because people who try to hurt you or who try to make you trouble, because due to anger, their anger arises unintentionally. So why you get angry at them? If you are because this anger is the not nature of that person. Person nature is good. When temporarily, when the mind is dominated by anger, no choice. And then person can hurt you or harm you. But if you use that logic, like for example, like your body, feel the pain unintentionally, but you will not get angry towards your body. So similarly, if you contemplate that person who are hurting you is unintentionally and have no choice because he's temporarily person is dominated by this affective emotion, anger. When anger subsides, person is normal. Nature is normal. So So this, then this we have to think, Shandadeva said. And then number two, then we, when anger arises, we have to further analyze, you know, who create the thing that make you really angry, you know. Further analyze. So here Shandadeva said, sometimes people, you know, hurt themselves like terribly. You know, people hurt themselves terribly when trying to get things they want. So people do this all the time. You can see people, you know, hurting themselves terribly, you know. They want something. But then there's no question about people who hurt others. You know, because if you're hurting yourself terribly because you try to get something you want, then if you didn't get, you will get angry. So you hurt yourself. In the West, people say self-hating, or people angry to yourself. So, of course, so then there's no question, Shandadeva said, no question about hurting others, you know, because hurting yourself, they will also hurt you in the process. So they are like, you know, sometimes, because they are like the wild animals, you know, destroy themselves, you know, unwittingly, you know, and sometimes like, you know, the children, you know, hurt themselves. Children stupidly hurt each other. We can see like children eating the battery. They don't know exactly, but actually he is hurting the children. You know? So, so similarly, this is Shandadeva saying that there's no question people hurt others because you are hurting yourself. Then there's no question, you know, people will hurt you. But if you replace with contemplation, like we are talking about meditation, if you replace with patience, will get a benefit for yourself and other, you know, yourself benefit, because yourself on incredible good merit, which is continuation, you will carry this forever, you know. If you hurt themselves, then actually hurting yourself too, because you plant incredible negative karmic seed, you will carry this, and nobody will carry, you know. That's very important to contemplate and to think about this Shantideva's, you know, this incredible meditation. Now next he said, when people hurting you, right, the people are naturally either, you know, they are nasty or noble. Naturally we have to analyze the people, you know, somebody hurting you, somebody making you trouble. Are they naturally either, their nature is negative or the noble? We have to think about. If people who are hurting you, they are naturally negative and nasty, why do you expect them to be otherwise? And why you get upset? It's just like fire nature is naturally heat, you know. So, you know, if you put your finger in the fire, you know, it's nature's heat. Whom to blame, you know? You can't blame for the fire. Fire nature's heat. Fire nature's hot. But if you put your finger inside the fire, whose fault is it? Not fire's fault. Nature's heat. So you shouldn't put your finger inside the fire, right? So similarly, and then if, why do you angry at them? If they occasionally act nasty, it's ok. occasionally. Their nature is noble, you know. Their nature is pure. And then occasionally, like temporarily, and why you get angry, you know, we should contemplate and we should use all these method and meditation in your daily life. Then third, he said, you should rather get angry at the true source of anger, you know, really. The thing itself that drives the anger is actually, we call the mental afflictions, not the person. You know. The person nature is noble, you know. It's, you see, if the person not angry, nature is very good, normal. You know. When anger arises, this is kind of like occasionally, temporarily. And so what happens is we get angry toward the person, not the mental afflictions. So you should angry toward the mental afflictions too. Afflictions are the inner destroyer, what we call. If there is no mental affliction, there is no external enemy. You will not find one external enemy. If the mental is calm, you know. If the mind is very calm and the peace, noble, you will not find any one single enemy. All these, generally speaking, what we are talking about, if the enemy is not existing from the side of the object, it's just designated by the mind. Like, so, let me give you one example, you know. If something happened, if there are three persons, right? One is Bodhisattva, you know. Number two is somebody who receives some teachings and some information about practice, patience, or contemplation of the patient. Number three is person is totally ignorant. Nothing know about Dhamma or teaching or meditation. So same thing happens to these three persons. And you know, like, for example, a robber come and steal $100 each. So what Bodhisattva, that person will think? And what person who receives some teaching will think? And what ordinary people, then they will get angry and blame other and destroy yourself. But the noble person, you know, like Bodhisattva, will not angry, you know, I'm very happy, you know, I will rejoice. Give. Same things happen, right? But the robber is still $100 with each, this Bodhisattva. And this, you know, this person who receives some teaching, and then person who has no idea about teaching will get angry and destroy, retaliate, and terrible suffering, you know. But these two persons not suffering, you know. Same thing happened. If so, this is what we are talking about here. You should rather angry, you know, who mental afflictions are the actual who cause you angry. Then number four, reason is ultimately you missed it, you know, like what we call missed it. Created the person who is causing you angry. So Buddhist perspective, you know, Shantideva said, the world is nothing, the world, you know, like this. World is nothing but colors and shape until your mind conceives of it in a certain way, you know. The way things appear to you is not, it is not matter of immediate choice, you know. It is the force of our karma, you know. Ultimate source of anger is our karmic seed. You know, that's the you know, we think about these four qualities, you know. He Shantideva said, no, he is talking about four qualities. Okay, number one quality is we're talking about the functioning things, you know. Functioning things. we're talking about the functioning things or things that does do something, you know. The functioning things are do something, right? Number two, talking about changing things means impermanent. You know, it's changing, your mind is changing, your feeling is changing, your relationship with others, everything is fluctuating, changing. And number three is, he's talking about here, a caused thing, which is produced by convenience cause, right? And number four is a produced thing, something which is made. We cannot separate this four. These four should go together, you know. So when anger arises, right, a functioning thing, you know, is something, you know, and then changing things, and then cause things, produce things, all these come together. Anger arises, right? Cause, which if you produce karmic seed, right, cause, negative, it will produce a negative result, right? If you plant the, you know, poisonous seed, it will only produce poison, you know. If you plant the medicine seed, it will produce only medicine, not poisonous seed. So similarly, if you plant the, you know, positive seed, it will produce you happiness and joy. If you plant the negative seed, it will produce negative. So when anger arises, you will plant the negative seed. Functioning things, cause, produce, and all this. We cannot separate this. So we have to think that these four qualities must go together, you know. You cannot separate these four causes. Whenever something happened to you, you know, like if things are functioning, must have these four causes. You know, cause, conditioning, who made this anger, you know. So this is very so this is why it is impossible. Shantideva said that our anger in our entire world would have come from some unchanging, unproduced, like unchanging and uncaused God, you know. Not something like that. It comes from causes and conditions. No cause, no seed, no result. So so this is one method, you know, Shantideva was saying it is very important we contemplate something like that. And then next, if we practice this, you know, step by step, and thinking about all this and contemplation, what Shantideva said. Then next he said, so now people, you know, people hurt you, you know, like harsh speech. You know, somebody, you know, speech is word, right? It's not. Speech is not body, right? So somebody speak you harsh, it will hurt you, right? But actually he said, word cannot hurt you because Shantideva said, the mind doesn't have a quality like body, you know, characteristic body, shape, color, you know, pinpoint, you know, like this. You can pinpoint the body, you know. Mind doesn't have this kind of characteristic. But have body or the characteristic that can be affected by others' words. Of course, somebody hurt you, upset you, or say something very nasty, you know. Whether you want to identify with this particular body and get upset about and offense is only matter of habit. Seeds are very difficult to break. You know, it's hard to believe, you know. When we talk about you get angry, you know, you will plant the karmic seed, you will carry this continuing, your mental continuation. Hard to believe, you know. You can't see. Not like external things we can see and we can, oh, this is shape, color, you know, but when we talk about karmic seed, which is internal, you know, internal qualities, but hard to believe. So you must, something happen like this, you must use every opportunity to change this kind of attitude, you know. And it means you are thinking about you will replace patience instead of replacing the retaliation for some harsh speech. You know what I mean? So replace with patience. If you replace with patience, you will become a noble person during that period. You know? You're not like ordinary person. Ordinary people, if you hit one, they will hit you twice. If you hit twice, they will hit you four times. It's ordinary people do like this. But people who have some teaching and meditation, they will not do like this. You know? If somebody speaks you harsh, you know, they have to think. You have to contemplate. have to think about the quality of the patient. Patient is actually quality of the mind. You know? If I practice patient, then what happened? I will plant a good seed. This seed will continuation I will carry. You know? Then it will benefit for me, not only temporarily, but ultimate. It will help me to achieve a good result. So therefore, you know, harsh is, so it is like relations, they are saying we can take every opportunity to practice patience. But imagining is very difficult, you know. It's habit of the mind, you know. We do bad things too, you know. We are very used to be. If somebody is hunting, you know, hunting, habit. If somebody, you know, like drinking, habit. Just a little bit drink, then start like that. If somebody, it is habit of them. We are not used to be like this. If we change the attitude, we will change the mind. Just like you use ordinary perspective, what we do. But if you are mechanic, you know, fixing car, you know, habit like this. Computer, you fix the computer, it's your habit, you know, very. And you fixing it, later become natural, very easy to go, I will fix the computer, very easy, I know how to do this like this. Because you have in mind. But we are not used to be thinking, change this attitude, like practicing patience, we will do it, you know. It's exactly, because our mind nature is noble. Our mind nature is pure. You know? If the mind nature is impure, then impossible we will do. But it's not. So therefore, so this is some method, you know, Shantidana said, very good, to stop anger. Okay, next is having generated the awakening mind. Beings to be happy, why should I become angry if they find some happiness themselves? If I wish for all sentient beings to become Buddha worship through the three realms, then why am I tormented when I see them receiving very mundane respect? If a relative for whom I am caring and to whom I must give many things, should be able to find their own livelihood, wouldn't I be happy rather than angry? If I do not wish for being to have even this, how can I wish for them to awaken? And they, where is their awakening mind and want to become angry? and other things. So we are talking over here, awakening mind, here we are talking about all, the Bodhisattva mind. Bodhisattva mind. The Bodhi means enlightened. Chitta means Sanskrit. Bodhi means enlightened. Chitta means mind. Enlightened mind. Altruistic mind. So mind. The enlightened mind, altruistic mind is mind is thinking for others, you know, caring for others. You know. So this is this kind of mind we are talking about here. So here's some method, Shantideva said. When we get angry, you know, so then we have no opportunity to develop this kind of mind, you know, so like Buddhi mind or enlightened mind. You know. What happened is next, he said, reacting to the happiness and misfortune of others. So this is very good. He gave here. We sometimes get upset or angry about the happiness or the good fortune of enemy or somebody. We don't like it. Person who are out of jealousy. But Shantideva said here, you should think very carefully, analyze very carefully when something happened like this. You should rejoice their senses as their good qualities, seeing and being happy about their good qualities. Actually will become you the cause of your obtaining this good quality yourself. So here he's talking about if you, when somebody, you know, we are talking about here like anger, you know, when somebody hurt you, you retaliate, then what happened? There's no space of this Buddha mind, like, so tell it. And then you plant the negative seed. And other people who also plant the negative seed. So what happens is, if you rejoice, actually you will get good benefit. It's the number one benefit. In this short run, you will feel joy yourself. You're not angry, you have joy and happy, right? You're rejoicing other people, you know, with quality, you will get married. Actually, it is obtaining merit for yourself. Number two, karmically, you will be happy in the long run, you know. So you will rejoice with good qualities, you will plant the karmic seed. This karmic seed is mental continuation of the future, this life, or you know, this present life, you will carry it. And number three is having this positive attitude, attractive others in the Dharma, you know, you bring other people in the Dharma teaching, you know, like they can have some understanding of the teaching. Number four, the surest way to ruin your own happiness is to be unhappy and other happiness. Similarly, you should avoid, you know, getting happy about the misfortune of this you dislike or the jealous of people. You don't like these people. Oh, I'm glad. If I have enemies, oh, I'm glad something misfortune. I'm so happy now. Something like that, you know. Actually, he said, rejoicing in their misfortune is the number one. Misfortune doesn't help you at all. You know? It makes you upset. Doesn't help you. He's enjoying his fortune. And you jealous in him. It doesn't help you anything. You know? Number two, you can't take the critic for their misfortune anywhere. Shantideva said, annoying people are rare opportunity like, oh, many people make you angry. I'm not talking about like that, okay? Oh, annoying people are really good. I've plenty there. Many people make you angry. I'm not talking about this one. You have to listen very carefully what he's talking about. Running into someone who makes you angry is truly a rare opportunity because they provide you within chance to fight your own tendency to anger. So this is the point we are talking about. These irritating people will become real and real in your life if you stop getting angry when you meet them. As your anger, so what happens is, as your anger karmic wears out, and you don't create new bad karma. That's the point. That's the point we are talking about. You will burn the karma, plug. You will not plant new karmic seeds. That's what we are talking about here. These people will disappear or sometimes, right? Or they are your partner in reaching you to the paradise we are talking about. So paradise means you purify your mind, plus you're not planting new karmic seeds. That's the point, you see? If you plant, you're not planting new karmic seed of anger, plus you will burn that karma, you know. Then you will be close to the paradise, purify your mind. So that's the point he is talking. If you stop hurting other people, there won't be anyone else left to hurt you, Chandradeva said. You should treat everyone with as much respect as you have for respect to your teacher, the Lama. It is said, Buddha said in the sutra, you know, the feet of living being is placed. They create one world as the Buddha field. Through your kindness to all other beings, you plant the seed in the field of other people. So that's the part two. Which in turn create for you a Buddha paradise right here in the world which you live now. That's the point we are talking about here, Buddha said. So when so the field of living being is the place where we live, right? That create our world as a Buddha field through your kindness, right? Through your kindness, through your compassion, through your contemplation of this such an incredible practice of the patient or whatever, your meditation, you plant seed in the field of other people. You know? Other people get seed, not only you. Other people plant seed, which in turn for you to be born to the pure realm. This is two qualities. Understand? So if we are ordinary person, you know, it doesn't matter, you know. Anger is good, you know. I should be angry, you know. Some people, I should be retaliate. If you are, I'm not retaliate, I'm not hero, you know. I should do something bad when somebody hurt you. But this is not what we are told here. Shantideva teaching is kind of like different, you know. Actually, he's giving you more ultimate happiness, not temporary. Like, if ordinary people, if somebody hurt you, if you retaliate, it's temporary solution, like, can't solve problem. Here, Shantideva is talking about how to stop the real cause of problem, which is we are talking about this this unsubdued mind, you know, mind, this, our mind is very unsubdued, unstable, you know, and mind is, Shantideva said, it's just like, you know, like white elephant, you know, destroy. What happened? White elephant will destroy the house, destroy people, everything destroyed. See, the mind is like white elephant, you know. First it will destroy yourself, and then destroy others. No question. So if we contemplate this, you know, Shantideva's method, one by one, I think it's very, very effective and very useful in our life. Anyway, thank you very much. And next Friday we have no teaching, right? We have 3 days retreat, Sunday, Sunday.